Under Suzuki's Scorch Racing Nissan S15 has always been a crowd favourite here at World Time Attack Challenge. Until now though, there's been very little information out there about what makes this car tick. We've taken the opportunity to get an in-depth tech tour of the S15. The turbocharger is one of the key aspects of any of these time attack cars, and in this case the Scorch Racing S15 is fitted with one of the new Garrett GTX 3584Rs. This uses a V-band exhaust housing with a single scroll inlet. The boost control is via a TurboSmart external wastegate, and heat control here is a major issue. You can see that the team have built a guard around the turbocharger to control the heat in the engine bay, and this results in a lot of heat being placed into the wastegate. In particular, this can result in problems with the wastegate diaphragm rupturing. So the team have actually plumbed a supply of fresh air directly from the front bumper straight onto the head of the wastegate in order to cool it and make sure that it remains reliable in the heat of battle. On the inlet side of the engine, there's a Hypertune inlet plenum fitted with a set of injected dynamics ID2000 injectors to supply the E85 fuel that the engine runs on. In order to make sure that the engine remains reliable under the extremely high lateral G-forces that these cars are pulling, a full dry sump lubrication system has been fitted. This takes the engine oil and extracts it out of the sump, and it stores it in a remote reservoir. An external pump then sucks the oil from the reservoir and pumps it back through the engine. This ensures that regardless of the acceleration, braking or cornering loads, a constant supply of high pressure oil is always available to the engine. A change this year to the drivetrain has been made. Previously the car ran the older Holinger RD6 six-speed sequential gearbox that is manually actuated by the driver. For this year the team have switched to the later model Holinger paddle shifted gearbox, which is actuated via air. The driver now can change gears both up and down using paddles on the steering wheel. Upshift is completed under full throttle. The clutch isn't needed after the car leaves the pits. In order to actuate the upshift, the MoTeC ECU cuts ignition momentarily to allow the next gear to be engaged. On the downshift, a throttle blip is done automatically via the Bosch drive-by-wire throttle body to match revs for the next lower gear. Another change for 2017 is to the electronics package on the car. Previously running the older MoTeC M800 ECU, the team have now swapped to the new generation MoTeC M150, which is running MoTeC's GPRP, or General Purpose Race Paddle Shift package. This controls the engine as well as the paddle shifted gearbox. The driver display is via a MoTeC C125 dash, which keeps the driver up to date with what's happening, including the MoTeC shift light module, and this is also the central logging location where all of the log data from the engine and chassis can be extracted. A MoTeC PDM30 and CAN-based keypad is also included to replace the traditional fuses and relays that we'd normally find on a car. The MoTeC PDM30 is a solid state power distribution module which controls power distribution to all of the engine's vitals as well as the other electronic components on the car. Every year we see the power levels at World Time Attack increase, and for 2017 the Scorch Racing team have also added a 200 horsepower shot of nitrous. Now traditionally the nitrous systems at World Time Attack have been used either right through the rev range or alternatively as an anti-lag measure to help spool a really large turbo. The Scorch Racing team are using it in a slightly unique way, with the Garrett GTX 3584 turbocharger being essentially at its limit. The team are enabling the nitrous flow above 7500 RPM when the driver's at full throttle, and this helps top up the power at that higher RPM range right up to the engine's 9500 RPM limit and helps extend the power band of the engine. The nitrous system is managed via the MoTeC M150 ECU, so it can be programmed to bring in the nitrous based on gear, engine speed and the driver's throttle position. Now when the nitrous system is active, additional fuel is required to meet the additional oxygen that's being injected via the nitrous oxide. This is handled in two ways. First of all, the nitrous system here is what's referred to as a wet system. This means that nitrous oxide and fuel are both injected via the nitrous nozzle fitted pre-throttle body. The MoTeC M150 ECU can then be used to trim the fuel delivery as required in order to ensure that the air-fuel ratio is exactly what the team wants. Now, with a light two-wheel drive car like this, despite the high downforce from the aerodynamics on the car, traction is always an issue. And this is where power management is very critical. In this case, the boost is controlled via the M150 ECU based on gear and throttle position. This ensures that the amount of power that the engine is producing can be accurately mapped to the amount of traction available from the track. This means that in low speed corners where the car is heavily traction limited, the boost is lower, and this makes it easier for the driver to control the car. Of course, even with these strategies, traction control is still vital, and here the MoTeC M150 provides an advanced traction control strategy where ignition and fuel cutting can be used to control engine torque and manage any wheel spin that does occur. Aerodynamics is understandably a really critical part of any of the Pro or Pro-Am class cars here at World Time Attack. Scorch Racing have been working closely with Andrew Brilliant from AMB Aero. Over the last 4 years they've been competing here at World Time Attack, and each year small improvements have been made to the aero package. As you can see, the entire outside body of the S15 is now carbon, combined with a large front splitter as well as that large rear wing and the rear tunnel diffuser in order to optimize the downforce as well as the aero balance from the car. Certainly this S15 is always one to watch, and we admire Under Suzuki's commitment building this car and developing it essentially as a one-man team with some of his friends back in Japan. We wish them all the best for the rest of their event here at World Time Attack. That video, make sure you give it a thumbs up, and if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week, and if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You'll learn about performance engine building and EFI tuning, and you'll also have the chance to ask questions which I'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so follow the link to claim your spot.